This is Kinangop region, which is the mother region of all GOA ministries. It is in this region, in Donyonjeru, Kinangop area, Nyandarua County, that we started GOA. And we have children's homes here, two of them, and many, many churches. We have come here to empower the pastors and the members and the ministries of GOA in this region from the effect of COVID-19 that has really hit them hard. So we've been here since yesterday Sunday, where we ministered to two churches, Kirarwa Church with Pastor Joshua there, and Tegatherega Church with Pastor Mushururu, who is also the assistant chief of that area. And it's a blessing to have Pastor, who is also an assistant chief. Then we finished day one and came back to spend the night here at Tumaini as we interact with the children. We had a great reception, huge welcome. Children were so excited because the last time we met, it is when that I had come here to fight together with them, the Kenya Power and Lighting Company, because of being in darkness for 4 months. And this morning we woke up to a great fellowship where we shared God's word in Colossians chapter 3 and verse 23 and 24. About serving, the right attitude of serving, knowing that there's a reward that is waiting.
Yani neno la Mungu linasema chochote kile unachofanya, fanya kama unafanyia Mungu. Unajua Mungu aliyeniumba, nikimfanyia chochote nitafanyia kwa moyo wangu wote, kwa roho yangu yote. Na ndio wakati tunakumbuka amri zile kuu, zinatuambia tumpende na akili zetu na roho yetu na mwili wetu na chochote kile tulicho nacho.
And after that great breakfast, well, the children were extremely excited. I really want to thank Hope for Nations. Hope for Nations is the initiative that we created on April 1st in response to COVID-19 to keep hope for children and adults and everyone alive and to inspire hope during the COVID-19 days. So out of the donations that we've been receiving for COVID-19, Hope for the Nations, We gave the children a treat here this morning with the bread and soda, very prestigious things for the kids. And we had a wonderful time of fellowship, eating together. And I just started my day very well. I would love to do this many more times.
We want to serve breakfast to you because it is important that we think about service. We want to serve breakfast to you, and we want to serve and celebrate coming of electricity.
And that time to make the story short, I can give a barua for TSC. I'm going to give my service to them. It was something that could not understand. You could not understand. Maybe in the spiritual area that I'm going to give. And we decided with no money, with nothing, and started the ministry of Glory Outreach Assembly. Being our pastor, our Bishop David Munyere Tagan. Now, we are talking now. He has the ministry, and then after that, he started this from the house there. I know a story better.
They are just taking well. Just because of you, thank you, and God bless you. Thank you for the service.
happy. Right now, I'm very cool because this is our first time to get breakfast like this. I appreciate so much.
My name is Pastor Samuel, the manager of Tumaini Complex and Tumaini Children's Home. We are so much grateful to God for giving us a chance to serve in Tumaini. Tumaini has 90 kids, we've got 50 boys and 40 girls. And we are so much grateful because of the love that we receive from friends, donors, our bishop, the head office. We don't have enough words to thank and to say thank you. We are so much grateful. We have got enough food, we have got enough good shelter, good beddings, whatever a child needs, all the basic needs of a child are catered for here. The parental love is offered. We have got the parental organ here. We have got aunties and the caregivers who help the kids to feel they are in the place they are supposed to be, and they are not harassed the way they were harassed outside before they came to Miami.
So I thank the Lord for this far. I take also this chance to thank Bishop David Dagana for the work that he is doing and for the love that he is showing unto us. We had no parents, we have no parents, and now Bishop is taking care of us, showing us the love that a father should give us. So we are happy because of him.
So we started the day well, and then went to Murungaro Church. Murungaro Church was started in 2004, and this is a church that is situated in a very strategic location on the Naivasha Murungaro Road, just 800 meters away from Murungaro Town. In this land, we have drilled a borehole, and that borehole, it has water. But then, all what is lacking is a pump and the electricity in the area to be able to pump that water out to the church members, to the community. And it's very sad when you see the water there and people are still suffering. But we pray together and we have believed today that this is a new beginning, and we are trusting that we're going to find somebody who is going to install for us a water pump to get the water out of that borehole. And probably solar system to pump it out, or electricity, so that it can be taken to the community. Our vision was to spread to the community and use it for evangelism. It still is until now.
My name is Pastor Wanyoike Francis. I'm pastor in GOA Murungaro, Murungaro Town. And I wish to thank God because of giving us this opportunity to meet with our bishop. And also I want to talk about the church. Glory Outreach Assembly Murungaro started in Murungaro location about 88 meters from Murungaro Town on the way to Naivasha Town. That is the church that Murungaro where is, and I want to thank God for that God has given us to reach and reach in this area. First is about the borehole we have here. To kama ikuwa completed, nadhani hiyo borehole ingesaidia community na pia isaidie church. Hii ni sasa tunaomba kwa ambao waweza kutusaidia kupata fedha ya kufanya hiyo boho ili iweze kutumiwa na maji in a community in this area and also the members of this church. Hiyo ni kitu ya kwanza. Ya pili ni tuwe na kanisa ambayo ingekuwa ni permanent church. Hata tunaomba hata head office watusaidie kufanya evangelist this area ili tuweze kuwafikia and reach na kanisa letu lipanuke. Hiyo ni mambo ambayo iko ndani yetu na tungeomba Mungu atusaidie ili tuweze kufikia hayo.
And we are encouraged by the words of Habakkuk in chapter 2 and where he says, even though a vision may tarry, it shall surely come. That vision of using that water in Murungaru Church still remains relevant to us. And it still speaks that one day that will happen. So pray for us. And if the Lord speaks to you about helping us to unlock the potential that is in that water, in that borehole, in that church, talk to us. Then we went to Matudura Church with Pastor Germano there and his family. They are happy people. We just joined them as we worshiped with the Lord together.
Kwa majina naitwa Pastor Germano Haberu. Na hapa pamoja nami ni bibi yangu anaitwa Anne Wanjiku. Sisi ndio tunahudumu hili kanisa la Glory Outreach Service Matudura ambapo tulianzisha kwa neema za Bwana mwaka wa 2008 na mwezi wa 10 tarehe 26 tukiwa na bibi yangu na watoto wangu na kutoka hapo diposa tukaingia kwa hii center sababu hili kanisa halikuanza hapa lilikuwa bali kidogo tukajeta hapa lakini kwa miaka 12 tumeona nguvu za Bwana kwa sababu tulikuwa tumekodisha nyumba hapa kwa center. Baada ya hiyo ndio tukanunua kuaja pahali but unfortunately kukawa na shida tukanyang'anywa hiyo shaba lakini Mungu akatujalia na mahali hapa tumejenga hii kanisa lakini hapa ni kukodisha na we are now 3 years old here. Kwa hivyo huu uwanja sio wetu, ni uwanja wa kukodisha, lakini bado tunaamini ya kwamba Mungu atatupea pahali ambapo tutajengea Mungu hekalu. Tuko na members 39. We are 39. Na kanisa linaendelea vizuri sana. Maono yetu ni kupanua hii kazi ya Bwana kwa sababu hata saa hizi ninaongea hapa nimefungua kanisa lingine upande wa Kalau kwa center inaitwa Rubie which is 3 weeks old. Na hilo kanisa limeendelea vizuri sana. Na kwa uwepo wa Bwana na kwa baraka za Bwana hilo kanisa sasa tuko na uwanja ambapo tutaanza kununua.
And then we proceeded on to Engineer Church which we planted 1 year ago. It's amazing how the Lord has moved the hearts of people in that area. And the church is almost full right now. They are looking into buying that plot on which they have built. And they will be doing a fundraising on December 6th to raise the money, $1.3 million, which is $13,000 to be able to buy that property. And it belongs to them. It's another strategically located plot.
So we just celebrated the first anniversary among the we would have created challenges here and there. But in spite of those challenges, we have managed to rise from a membership of about 12 to now a membership of over 15. Both here and here, youth, Sunday school. So we have a good church, board of elders, and deacons who are doing a very good job. We want to thank Bishop Dagana because of the work he did to bring us from the ground to where we are today. We have had some challenges anyway because there was a time that we thieves came, we stole, and had chairs and
to other things, utensils, and so we went almost back to square one. But thank God we have forms that could not be stolen. These forms have a history because we got them from the other church and then we get them. They are the ones that remain, and up to now we are using them. The other challenge is that we are buying a church plot. This plot was donated by a very dear sister, her name Catherine Kehuri, who is also the director of Mona Children's Home. She donated this, and she gave us 1 year to pay. She gave us one year to pay. Unfortunately, due to COVID-19, we stopped the Harambee. And now that they have opened, we are beginning. We are required to raise 1.3 million, which is this month. We are able to buy that. We shall have a rich mindset, a greater achievement. So we are giving our well-wishers and supporters to be sure that their whole leadership to support us in this world. Because we are in the intent of the gospel, north, south, east, west. Soon we are going to open another church because now our membership can start a church. So we believe that God is going to help us to achieve the objective of the Great Commission that we have been allowed to carry out.
I mean, the church is right in Nigeria, which is now the district headquarters for this region, where all the offices are, and a very high population, the business community. And we pray that God is going to provide the resources to be able to do that between now and December 6th. Matudura Church is also praying that the Lord will enable them to stop leasing the ground and be able to buy. When I hear these needs, I say, Lord, you own a cattle on a thousand hills, and silver and gold belongs to you. And friends, as you watch this YouTube channel, you will come across many, many different opportunities through which you can serve the Lord, through which you can make a difference. Feel free. Anytime you hear something here and you feel that God is speaking to you, please just let me know and we'll be able to do it together, and God will take the credit. Thank you. May the Lord bless you. God be with you. Thank you.